Top of the year to you. Happy Monday night and 2018. This new year is bringing in new leadership in the Twin Cities of Minneapolis and St. Paul. Tonight, we're going to put the spotlight on the City of Lakes.
That's right. We sat down one-on-one with Minneapolis Mayor-Elect Jacob Frey to talk Super Bowl, policing, affordable housing, and more. You're moving from council member to mayor. Yeah. Going to be sworn in, part of it, tomorrow.
Yeah.
Are you nervous? Are you excited? Are you comfortable? Are you eager? Like, where are you at?
I'm excited. I mean, this is my dream job, and I want to make sure we do it exceedingly well. So obviously there's some changes in my personal life, in my public and professional life, but you know, we've got one hell of a team around me right now, and I'm excited for the change that we can make and the people we can help.
RT Ryback, can he help you with your transition, right?
Yeah, a ton. I mean, and who knows more about being the mayor in the city of Minneapolis than RT Ryback?
What was the best advice he gave you?
The best advice that he gave me, actually, which was just following the election, was take a couple days, recuperate, and get ready, because it's going to be a wild ride.
Police community relations is going to be one of the big ones, both here and in St. Paul. Is that a department that you think you're going to micromanage, or you let off the leash and let the chief do his thing?
I don't think it's my place to micromanage the police department. We want to hire talented individuals and then trust them to do an excellent job. Now, are there certain areas where I am going to step in and say, hey, we do need to make a firm policy shift? Absolutely, there will be.
So after Jamar Clark got shot, we all remember this, there was an occupation of the 4th Precinct.
Mm-hmm.
If you were mayor at that time, how would you have handled that situation?
I would have done things differently. I think we would have had a good communication process and pipeline set up from the get-go, but also I would have been more visible and present.
Do you think the Minneapolis Police Department has a problem with shooting citizens unjustly?
Yeah, absolutely. We've got an issue. It has happened. And we need very specific reforms that are in place to prevent that.
What are your ideal reforms?
There are some obvious ones. You know, I believe that officers should have to exhaust all reasonable alternatives before they resort to deadly force. But if I had to choose one issue that was the most important to me over these next coming years here, it would be affordable housing. And right now, that's very quickly becoming not the case. You know, rents are skyrocketing out of control, and people are being displaced from the neighborhoods that they've grown to really love. And that ain't okay. And so, yeah, we're going to be laying out a very clear policy as to how you create and retain affordable housing, as well as working with tenants to make sure that they have the protections that they need.
As the new face of the city of Minneapolis, I mean, again, how are you handling the world's microscope of the Super Bowl going to be here just around the corner?
Well, I think it's an excellent opportunity to highlight that which sets us apart in Minneapolis.
Are we ready?
We are ready. We are the bold north here. We have a wonderful city to highlight. And we're going to be doing it in an amazing way.
Is this something that you want to do for the long run, to be the mayor of Minneapolis? Or is this something you want to put on your resume and have higher hopes for another job?
No, I don't have higher aspirations. I don't. There are things that I want to get done. You know, I'm a believer that being a public servant is not about being somebody. It's about doing something.
Mm-hmm.
There are things that I want to get done in this role. There are ways that I think we can just quite simply help people. Which, at the end of the day, I mean, that's what politics is about. And once we've gotten those things done, I'm be very happy doing something else.
Good to talk with him today. He has a private swearing-in tomorrow, right? It's just a private ceremony so that we have a mayor, so the torch is passed, at least legally. And then there's a public inauguration on January 8th. I asked him, what's the first thing you're going to do? What are you going to change first thing, first day? And he said that, as a council member, he knows this. Council members and city council don't have access to the mayor's office. Their key card doesn't work to get into the office. And he said, I'm going to change that. They can come in anytime they want, and if they have, you know, good ideas, they want to sit down and chat, they have access, literally access, to come and talk to me. I thought that was kind of interesting.
That is interesting, because our outgoing mayor, Betsy Hodges, was also a council member for years and years and years. Mm-hmm. So they already have relationships with some members of the council. But we're also seeing a brand new council in Minneapolis,
right?
So things are going to be changing. St. Paul is too, right?
That's right. So Mayor-elect Melvin Carter is going to be sworn in tomorrow as well. And we haven't touched base with his camp yet, but we're hoping to get in touch with him and do a one-on-one and kind of bring you the same flavor, get to meet him a little bit on tomorrow's show.
Both really young mayors with high ambitions.
Super young.
Pretty cool.